Good morning, Craig Howard here. I'm in the dining hall here at Camp Galilee, and we have honestly been having an amazing week here. It has been a time of just exciting things happening with kids' lives, just such bonding and unity in the group. And I told the counselors this morning in our counselors meeting that when I woke up this morning, the first word that came to my mind was thankful. I've got Mark sitting here with me. Say hi, Mark.
Hey, everyone.
But Mark's he's our pastor in resident, and he's been just a tremendous encouragement to both me and the kids. But we came down to counselor's meeting this morning, and we started talking about how thankful we should be for how well the kids have been, about how good the Bible studies have gone, about how God has blessed us with good weather, and on and on and on it went. And I was drawn to a passage in Colossians chapter 3, verses 15 through 17, and it really kind of breaks things up in three different sections. It says, "Let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which you were indeed called in one body, and be thankful." So the first thing it says is, be thankful for peace that God brings to our hearts and lives. If you're going through a difficult time and you spend time in God's presence, or whether you're not going through a difficult time, and you spend time in God's presence and you find that peace in your heart, don't forget to give God thanks. But then he goes on and says, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching and admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs with thankfulness in your hearts. He says, next thing, be thankful for the word of God in all its various forms that it comes to us. Sometimes it comes to us in a song. Sometimes it comes to us through something we read. But he says, let the word of God dwell in you richly, and then be thankful for having the opportunity to let that dwell in you richly. And then it says, and whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. So he says, now you're to be thankful for peace, be thankful for the word of God, and then be thankful for all that God allows you to do. You know, sometimes I realize what we do is stressful. And sometimes it's hard to be thankful for those things. And sometimes what we do is exhausting. I think Mark would agree with me that both of us are pretty well shot right now.
Yeah.
We'd like to go take a nap.
Our own bed looks really good.
Yeah. we'd like to go take a nap. But and all the counselors and all the kids, everybody is tired. I can't get this eye to open up all the way. It's tired. But I need to give God thanks for all that he allows me to do. And you do too. You do too. You know, this week, this year at camp has been physically the hardest for Mark and I. Mark just went through back surgery. I'm still recovering, and now my other knee is going bad. And so it's been a struggle for me physically. It's been a struggle for Mark physically. And yet I'm thankful to be here. And Mark's thankful to be here. And we're thankful that God continues to use us, even though we're not at our prime anymore. And even though we're not the best we can be anymore, even though we're not the best that we once were, I'll put it that way, anymore, God still uses us. And that's amazing, and that's exciting. And I'm so thankful for that. So remember the importance of giving God thanks in all that you do, in all the ways he uses you, in all the ways that he touches your life. And you'll find that if you're willing to do that, you'll find if you're willing to take time to give God thanks, it'll lift your heart. It'll encourage you. It'll strengthen your spirit. You can either focus on the problems you have in life, or you can focus on the blessings. I choose to focus on the blessings and be thankful, or at least I'm trying to. Hope you will too. God bless you. I'll see you Monday. We're going to wrap up camp today. Tomorrow's our last day, and we're going home tomorrow. But today's our last full day of camp. So you have a great day. God bless you, and I'll see you on Monday. Take care.